Hello, we're on page resh, and we're in the second column of the Elo HaMokesh Adnictus Barosh Zer Anpin. Now we're talking about the Mokin coming into Zer Anpin. Afshi Hikarim Nisharim Oinin Lamala Barosh. So their root remains above them, on top of the head. Mikal Makom Hare HaRasam Nafkin, but nonetheless, the radiance from them comes out. So he says, what does that mean? The Yodzech and the Rosh come out from the head, call Chad Besitroi, each one on its own side. Call Ech Bechem Yodzech. Mitzad Shalom, the Haile Rebumbo, Chachoch, Be Yodzech, Be Meir, Be Kat Yomim, Shem Sfiris Chesed Netzach, Shel Zer Anpin, Umbo Chabina, Meir, Be Kol Smol, Be Kat Smol, Shem Smiris Gevur of the Hod, Miss Pashtin Bakal Gufa, and they spread throughout the entire body. Nimsa Sha'aras Mohim Chachma Bina, Miss Pashtin Bakal Gufa, Zer Anpin, the Elan Ve'elah Rabishneha Bemoch Machachma Bina, and the Mishachim Abba Ve'ima that really come originally from Abba Ve'ima. Mishabrechabisre Mohim, they join together in two Mohim, Mishabren Bakalale Shneha Mohim. Shabiyamin is small, Shazer Anpin. He says they become, that is, this radiance becomes congealed or united, that is, the right and left lines of Zer Anpin. Umuchasidimo, and then I guess develops a third mochin, Vahamuach Ashlishi, Shuhumuach Adash, Bechololach, and Vishabacholol Emso. So in the third chamber, in the middle, Kolil Long, Kolil Eshnecha Mochim, Chachba Bina Yachad. So it has those two mochim in together, kihu moach amachria, because it's the balancing moach, and so it has them both. For the chen hu achid b'chai sitra of a b'chai sitra, so therefore it holds on to all sides. So he says, so b'chai sitra, so achus b'tzad zeh the hainu b'shnecha tzedadim yam and is small, that it shines on the two sides, left and right. So this is what he says. It's actually hold on to the moch of hachma should be yamin beitra agavura the das achus b'muach abina should be small. So these two mochim actually, or I guess it feels like they're like facing the other side and touching on to the, that is, to the sides. Umispashet b'kol gufa, and then they spread through the whole body. The ha'aras moach adas, and now we're talking about the ha'ara from the das. Miss Pasha Bakal the Guf Shazer Anpin spreads through entire body. The Haina Bakal the Shlosha Kavim, the three lines, Yamin small Emsa. Vis Aved Mineva, Naasim Min Hamuach Adas, and then from out of this Muach Adas, Ha'echa Bishnecha Mamochim Chachma Bina Yachad, that is really holding on to the two sides, Trey Gavani, two colors come out. Shnei Gavanim, Lovim Ve'edim, Edim are old two colors, white and red. A sheheba bechinas chesed v'din, which is the concept of chesed and din. Gavon lovon mukach is mekoach chachma muach chachma. So the right line for the koach of chachma, which is up above it and shining on it, the gavon edon mekoach muach bina. So he said kolulun kahada, and they're all joined together. V'shnecha gavonim kolulun ke'echa. They're the two. These two colors, red and white, joined together. Bechasana begavura shebemuach adas and the shkadim is and gavuros and the muach adas. I guess he means the abba side, the ima side come in and they join together. Umachayim umemakom amuach adas berosh zer anpin. Let's go to the muach adas zer anpin. The chayde bemetzach zer anpin. So he says this muach adas is located in the metzach zer anpin. Bein shtei hanayim, and it really is between the two eyes. Shuha neged muach adas, which is really where the muach of das is located, inside the head, behind the forehead, and shuhu keneged muach adas, and it's right between the eyes. Yotze sham or men mochim chokma bina. So from there, the light that comes from chokma bina comes out from that position behind the eyes, in the middle of the eyes. Bokeim in hametzach luchutz besod or makiv, and it breaks out from the forehead in the secret of the surrounding light. Biyored min hametzach laoyer lematach bin hanayim, and then it comes down. So this light now starts going downwards below the eyes. Nahir Anpui, and it has the effect of lighting up the faith. Umeir Sham es Apanim. And let's understand here is that the mocking of Chachma and Daas came together, and you have here now in the middle, in between the eyes, the place where Daas comes together. It's in the middle of the two of the other two. So now the two colors of that are inside, also inside of this moch Daas. Shnei gavanim gavani hapanim shehem lovan ve'edim me'irim v'zer anpin they testify about zer anpin who haben shall abba ve'ima, because now you see that the two colors are there, therefore you understand that it's related to abba ve'ima, the child. Ki gavan lovan who betzad emochem shekibu be'abba ve'gavan ne'edim who betzad emochem shekibu be'ima behema edu. So these two colors stand as witnesses. Shazir Anpin, who ben hanoilid ben atzav shnehim. So that's what the colors do for Daas. Vuhu ikri Daas, and it's called Daas. Vor hamakif azecha ben ikri Daas. Now he's saying that this is an or makif. So the more makif that came out from the Daas now is flowing down the face, is there Anpin. Yaaf shuhu or shall mochim chachma bina. So we understand that this is nothing more than the light of our good friends chachma bina. Below or Moach Hadas, and it's really a compilation of those two, and it's not the light of the Moach Hadas. Shemis Pashet Rak B'Sheish Kitzvay Seguf. This spreads only into the body itself, the six different parts of the body. Mikol Makom Nikra B'Sheim Das. Even so, it's called by the name of Das. Why? Al Shem Sheyotzi B'Bokeya M'Makom B'Das, because it comes out of the place of Das. Now, he just made a statement that actually the light that's coming out of this Daas is really the light of Abba Ve'ima in a combination. So it's not a light that is called the light of Daas, it's a combination light. But Daas Be'inyan Moach Daas Dezer Anpin. So let's talk about it, he says, Kasiv, it's written over there. He says, Kasiv Ki Kael Deus Yud Kevavke. So this is a plural, he says it's a Kael of Deus. Of two deos, or more than one, velo niskano alilos, and it doesn't set up these plots. Now, what is this talking about? Velo niskano alilos. Now, this is interesting. He says what the pasuk says niskano alilos. He sets up these strategies. Pirusho nisaken vuhuchnu. Pa'ulas shonos. He has many different kinds of ways he can go. He has different actions that he can take out. Valkein yesh the shul. So therefore, you have this question. He says, "Ma inin dechidas a pasuk l'sofa." So what's the beginning of the pasuk have to do with the end? Ki eza kesher yesh bein the das and nizga berosh a pasuk l'chasiyas a pa'ulas. So what does das have to do with all of these actions? Va'od. Not just question, not just that. Yesh the shol al masha kasi b'pasuk lo niskanu ba'alef. So he says al masha kasi b'pasuk. The pasuk says lamed aleph, which means negative, niskanu ba'alef. So therefore, it's set up with an aleph. V'korin lo, but the way we read it is with a vav. V'nisaktu b'vav. Now that's the way I read this. V'korin lo niskanu b'vav. B'vav. So it's low, which means for him or to him or something like that. So how do you put together the facts that you have? It's read one way and it's written another way. So let's look at the beginning where it says Kael Deus Hashem. So it's the God or the Kael, whatever Kael means, lush and kindness, is the Deus of Hashem. We already said lav gabav. Shishnei deos yesh b'zer anpin. He has das. It's split into two. Ki milvad muach das. Besides the muach hashibidayin docha b'kan adachsho that we've been talking about, yesh b'zer anpin od das elyon v'ne'elam. He has not just one das. It seems like he has another das. which is really in a higher level, because we understand the das that we deal with is always dealing with the body, which is the six kitzvot. But here we're talking about way up high. It's in the rosh, and he was talking about before the forehead and so on and so forth, right opposite the chamber. Umachriya b'nehem, and it balances them. Right, the other two it triangulates them. V'shorish min aponim, so v'sharsho min aponim shall erik anpin. Now, you want to know where this das comes from. I think that's what he's saying. He says its root is in the face of erik anpin. L'mitznan shnei deus elo, from the side of these two deus, nemer ha-pasuk ha-zecha b'shnech aponim, so therefore the pasuk says in different ways. Kimitzad das tachton, if you're talking about the das tachton, nemer below with the vav. This kind of alilos, and then you say that for him, he's picking up different kinds of strategies, and that's when you put the word vav. Mitzad das elyon, but when you're talking about the upper das, number below, and then it has an aleph there, which is a negative. This kind of aleph, so it's put together with an aleph. Labir of the varim who begin the ihu b'srei gavonim, and the reason for this that you have an upper das, it seems like we say upper das and lower das. So he specifies. He said, because that das tachton has two colors in it. So therefore, lo, for him, he has strategies of different kinds of, prepares himself with strategies. Now, what's that all about? Koloma lo lezer anpin. We're talking about him now. For him, zer anpin, nisakto v'huch nuchu pa'ula shonos. So are put together, arranged for him, different kinds of actions. In other words, he's a multiple action kind of guy. Lefamim chesed apamim din. Sometimes it's chesed, sometimes it's din. It goes different ways. Abitzad han hagas adas elyon. When you're talking about the das elyon, zer anpin. Which really came from the faces of Erik Anpin. I think I'm probably supposed to know how we got there, but I'm not sure that I think I need a little help on that. So let's see what else he says. Hare the Latika Kadisha Stimor. Latika Kadisha Hasasim Bakola Saga. So now we're talking about the Atika Kadisha, who's closed up, as we understand from any ability to reach it. Shuhu Erik Anpin, Vuhu Shor Shadaza Elyon, and he is the root of the upper Das. Alav Ne'emba B'Pasuk. So, in regard to him, the Pasuk says, Lo Niskanda Habalilah Ba'aretz. He should definitely not make plots, prepare pots. It's a negative. He does not prepare strategies. Because it's not put together by different actions. Because all of the actions, we're talking about this upper das, and shavos, they're all the same. All of them are a mixture of chesed and rachamim. Because it's coming from the head of Erik Anpin. They don't have that right, that left side at all. Erik Anpin, who rachamim gemurim, Erik Anpin is complete and total rachamim. So Rebbe Shoal, and he asks this question, my time in Niskanda Lahai? So Rebbe Ma Hatam, she Niskanda Halilu Shono, so why is it that you're strategizing all different kinds of, preparing all different kinds of strategies? L'zecha b'chadas ha-tachton shal zer anpin, and we're talking about the lower das now, it's strategic. Ha-richem das ha-tachton nimshach min sharsha elyon, so we understand that the das tachton is really an extension of the das elyon shehu shtei kasei kasfayim shel Erik Anpin. Let me read this again, because I thought he was talking here about the forehead of Erik Anpin, and now he's not. Ki harei gam hadas atachton nimshach min sharsha elyon. That's what I would have thought, that it was talking about the place in between the two eyes. So, but he says shehu shtei kasfayim shel Erik Anpin. So the two shoulders of Erik Anpin, now we're talking here about the goof, so it's related to the goof. So whatever flow comes down the right side and the left side ultimately appears at the shoulders, and the shoulders over there are the source of this second das. V'ketzad nimshach v'men ha'lilus ha'pa'ula shel din. So how is it that these strategies and actions that, in other words, the dinim that are going to come out, How, in fact, do they come out? Ki hatam hu, because the tam is begin the yaris trin chloke. Bifnei shechadas atachtom, because now you're coming down to the pool. Daas is once again, that middle line seems to be like a pool type of line where everything flows into it. He said, bifnei shechadas atachtom, yaris shnei chlokim. Shehem Chassad of Gevurah said it also inherited these two portions of red and white, which are Chassad of Gevurah. Chedek Chassad of Zer Anpin, for Chedek Gevurah's nose in the Nukva. So the Chassadim go to Zer Anpin, and the other go to the Nuk. Vekem Shekein Hared Sarech Lot Hared Lutzorech Yerushazu. Vekem Shekein. So that since that's the case, so that's it's the. This Daas is the inheritor of what's coming from up above. Tzorek HaDaas lihis pashit, because sheish sfiros shel zer anpin. So now it has to spread. Ki chelek ha-gevura tzricha lihis pashit k'day lihinos in the nukva, because the one has to spread, that is the gevura side, because it's ultimately going to the nukva. This is the reason why it starts spreading in the body of zer anpin. They have to also do that, because ultimately, as a gevurah shel hanukva, because they're going to go the same kind of idea, but ultimately they come and sweeten those gevurahs. And since Daas has now come to spread, because the sheish spheros of all the six spheros, so therefore it has to have different strategies because it's going many different places. Upaulos are different actions. According to Osa's spheros, Shabonis Pasha to Daas. This is letting you know that the spheros are independent in some way. They work together, but there's you have to have a strategy for being able to, I guess, penetrate them. So he says, "A sphere shibo nispashe to Daas im chesed o gevura o teferes." Whether you talk about the right line, left line, or middle line, v'chein nishar sphere bishar spheros, and then all the rest of the spheros, same thing. So he says, "Where am I?" The same thing. Okay, there we are. So we write like this. So now we have this. If you're chosid, do your chesed. So the same kind of idea. So if, I don't really understand pshat in the word tamim, but he says, let's see. In gibor tamim, if you're pure gibor, I guess it's pure din, he said to takam. So then you should, make yourself known. I guess it goes along with the word tamim. V'im ikesh tispatel. Okay, so then he says, then if you're crooked, then you continue the curve. V'hidach basukim elu amr Yaakov avida the Rivka imenu. So he said that to Rivka. He said, imenu. V'al pi hasod, and according to the so, then, Yaakov hu hadas. Let's say like Yaakov's the middle line. He's the das atachton. So we understand that the place of Yaakov is from the Chaz of Lamata. So this is what we're talking about, the place of this Daas. In the middle. V'hu ha-Daas tachton mispasha b'zer anpin. It spreads into Zer Anpin. Ki nishmas Yaakov avinu nimshach b'Daas tachton. They come out of the lower Daas. The Daas v'al ha-Daas tachton. And from this lower Daas, ha-mispasha ne'emach ha-pasuk, that is now going to spread. This is what the pasuk is talking about. In chaset is chasat. So looking at your right line, mitzad is pashtus adas b'sfiris acheset. As you see that it's spreading down the right line, im gibor tamim titamim. So if you also have this gibor, which is the left line, mitzad is pashtus adas b'sfiris agavura. So this is the concept of das spreading into the left line. He says in the sfiris agavura. Vim ikesh tispatel. So if it's I guess crooked, then you'll curve it around. Mitzad his pashtus adas the call the stadi aguf. This is really talking about what needs to happen to go this way, that way, and so on and so forth. Ki hadas mispashet sham bedrachim makumos, because it goes into twisted, different kinds of crooked paths. V'halilos arumomios. So it has to have deep strategies. In order to be able to figure out how to get to, I guess, to be able to move to the different places, kihud sarkli is pashet, because it has to spread, because all of the different chambers of the body. Hein bitzad yamim, hein bitzad small. V'chol b'kishut u'kim b'chavrim. The emes, the truth is, who ma she'amadu u'biara rachomen, there's chaverim, so the yeshiva had been talking about this, she'sod zeh shel his pashtus adas, this secret that we're talking about is how the das has to spread, that is the das atachton, b'sfiris chesed gevur maromas, d'chsev, you can see this in this pasuk, So he said then he spoke to Rachel because he is the brother of her father. So in other words, he related in that way, who Viki ben Rivka hu, and he's the also the son of Rivka. Now, why does he have to say all of these things? In other words, he's a close relative because he's the cousin. Viki ben Rivka hu, and then it has to say that he's the son of Rivka. Kimasha cause of lusha v'yaged. So what's this about? He says, whenever you see this word v'yaged, ha ukmuho. So lebarcha midah rebiurach chaverim. So outside, this had been explained once before by the chaverim. The kulu raza the hachmasa, that the whole thing is about so. Shebekal the bekomo shenizker bepasuk lushan hagada. Anytime you see the word hagada. So he's been saying things like the Haggadah of Rabbi Nuna Saba, Rabbi Yeba Saba, he's been saying that. He says, once again, Shebekal the Bekomash and Nizkar Bepasuk Lashon Haggadah, who bo la horos ad al sof al chokma al yoydah harumazim sham. So this is really talking about the upper das. V'raya lakach, and the proof of the fact that he's talking about that, what's this really talking about is the Chochmah ben Rivkahu, because it says he's the son of Rivka. Ben Rivka. So what do you need this for? Ben Yitzchak. Why didn't he say the Ben Yitzchak? Oh, okay. So he said, he should have said, if you want to introduce himself and tell him how close he is, he should have said Yitzchak. Elabikan Raya. But this is really a proof. Shahu remes that it's really a hint, l'so the chachma. Why? V'kulu remiza b'chachma. So now what does Rivka have to do with chachma versus Yitzchak? B'chachma so. So he said, v'kol ha'pazak remes b'chachma shahi chachma sod, which is the what we're doing is learning sod. Behind the ki Yaakov shahu sod das tachton ha'mispashet. So understand Yaakov, that's who Yaakov is. Amishuhu mispashe b'shtei sefiros chesed gevur. He's saying to them that I represent the middle line, but the lower das. He says b'shtei sefiros chesed gevur gam yachad. So he represents those two together. B'zesha amr Yaakov. This is what Yaakov says, quote, ki achi abihohu, that he is the brother of his father, of her father. Who b'midas ha'ramos, that is, in what? In the fact that he knows strategies. He knows how to trick people. Shuhu sod his pashtus das b'sfiris ha'gevura. So this is what he's saying. He says, how is it necessary to deal with gevura? That he has to spread, that das has to go into gevura. V'armen, then he says, v'ki ben rivkahu, and then he says he's also the son of Rivka. B'midas ha'tmimos, and that tmimos that he's talking about, which goes along with gevura, is very interesting. Not sure exactly understanding psychologically how it is that tmimos, the concept of tmimos, goes along with gevura. Because I guess if you look at gevura and when it comes out, there's no doubt about it. I'm not sure. Shuhu sod his pashtas adas b'sfiris ha'chesed. So that's also the sphera when he said ben Rivka, that it's talking about the fact that it goes into chesed. What does Rivka have to do with chesed? I would thought the other way. V'al chai ikri shlim b'kulo. V'al kein nikri Yaakov shalim b'kol. So therefore Yaakov is called that he's complete in everything. He said, "B'kol u'kamoshon ha'amar," as it said, like this, "Ish tam yoshev ohalim." So he's a straight, pure guy. Here's the word "tam" again, incidentally, that came from that pasuk, "Ish tamim." So v'tar gubachu gavar shlim. So it means to say that he's a complete man. What does that mean? Ha'luki Yaakov koye yoshev b'shnei ohalim shal chesed ha'gavura. So he's able to live in the two of them. So he's like the middle tent. And so he had both of them, Chesed and Gevura, together. Ube is achaze mechamenusa. V'ubo, that is, in this quality, nearest Amunah, that's where you see Amunah. Shehi Shleimus Hanhaga Zecheb Chesed V'Din. I just want to read that again because, as you know, I've sort of been trying to pin down the word Amunah, and since he brings it up again. So at the very top it says, Ish Tam Yoshev Ohalim V'chatargumo Gaver Shlim. He's a complete person. Hainu ki Yaakov koye Yoshev b'shnei ohlim chol chesed gevura v'hoye shole b'chesed gevura yachat ube is achze meramanusa. But the fact that you could put these two sides together, is he saying that that is the definition of amuna? Ubo niris amuna, that's where you see amuna. Shehi, then he says amuna is shehi shleimus hanhagas b'chesed v'din. Amuna means that the two sides are balanced and everything is running in the way of balance. Not sure, go on. V'gin kach v'gedei l'ramez so the zen, in order to have a reference to this so, shall his pashtus adas v'chesed the gavura, where it spreads into those two, k'siv v'yaged Yaakov, and it reaches that Yaakov, here's his word, v'yaged. Yaakov said these things over. K'asa v'chavakan v'pasak v'yaged Yaakov shuhu lashon hagoda haromez besod the Sod Kamo Shamarno, which is teaching us about this secret. I'm not sure I really understand, but Yage, just look at the word itself, is that the number 17 doesn't mean anything particular to me. So he says, Sod Kamo Shamarmar, Velok Siv, Velok Kosov Kan Lushan Vyomer. It doesn't say Vyomer, Kiposak Romez Kan the Sod, because here, instead of Yagade, I guess it's what he wants to say about Yagade, he wants to say that this is telling you that you're going to be talking about a sod. Okay, I think that's it for today, right? Okay. Thank you very much. Call to.